call in.
And his opponent, escorted in the ring by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, weighing at 242 pounds and hailing from Brooklyn, New York.
Only a short time ago, these two individuals, conspiracy here, tried to put the Red Rooster out of commission, didn't get the job done. Somewhere along the way, they're going to have to pay. The Brain can find all kinds of ways to get himself in trouble. Make him get rid of cigar, ref, and the hat. That's why you make him get rid of it. That's a weapon. Brawler,
come on, boy.
Formerly Steve Lombardi, now only wants to be referred to as the Brooklyn Brawler. I don't know why. I guess that's the title that the Brain gave him. What an arrogant individual. Of course, just to grow up and survive in Brooklyn, you got to be a tough guy. But they tried to do a number and should have done a number if they wanted to get the job done on the Red Rooster. They didn't get it done. Let's find out why not.
Brooklyn Brawler, I almost feel sorry for you because I've been where you think you're going. Weasel's in your ear telling you he's going to take you to the top. Well, it isn't going to happen, and it's not going to happen at the Red Rooster's expense. Heenan, I'm going to get to you. Trust me.
One very upset individual in the form of the Red Rooster. Sooner or later, this threesome is going to get together again. And it'll be interesting to see in which direction the Brain will be running to find a place to hide. In the meantime, Dave Stoudemire, not faring too well. Uh-oh, wow. That'll give you a negative attitude and make you wish you were home watching the telly or something. Lombardi can learn all kinds of nasty things now that he's under the tutelage of the Brain. And he's the type of individual who will listen. Whether he can do it inside the ring is something else. But the Brain at times can be overbearing.
Come on, boy. Come on.
As is obvious because of the lack of championships within the Weasel's family. None. Zero. So. And if he thinks he's going to get one from this guy, forget about it. Lombardi, former graduate of the Terry Garvin School of Self-Defense, now under the tutelage of the Brain. I don't know what else you could do to this guy to make him championship material. Some last-minute instructions here. No, he's not screaming at him like he used to the Red Rooster. He used to scream at that youngster and verbally humiliate him in public. You know, who could take very much of that? Stoudemire looked to be ripe for the pickings right now. Nice uppercut by Lombardi. Referee Dave Hebner warning him about the clenched fist, but not much you can do about it after it's done. Slammed him right in the corner. Where's he going now? Second turnbuckle on the inside. Challenge for the Brooklyn Brawler. Here's some of the action earlier on. Look at that. With that plastic, leather, whatever it is, right across the kisser. Then later on, he really started to open up. And then the finale right there sat right on the face of Stoudemire. Wow. And there's that horrible-looking cigar. Right now, let's go to the WWF.